Hello everyone, welcome to Android Libraries channel. Today we are going to implement selection dialog library in our project. So let's get started. There are two dialogs in this library. First one is single selection dialog, in which user can only select a single option in the dialog. And second one is multi selection dialog, in which user can select multiple options at the same time. To implementing this library, we need to copy this Maven URL and paste it in our project level Gradle file under the all project section. Second thing we need to do is to copy the dependency and then paste it in our build.gradle module level file and then sync our project. I have already synced the project because it takes some time. What we are going to do is to create a two text view. First one is for single selection and second one is for multi-selection. When a user clicks on the text view, we are going to show the dialog, and which user clicks on the particular option, we are going to show that option to the text view. I have already created this text view in a XML. So let's initialize this in our main activity.java text view TV single, TV multi. TV single equals to find view by id r.id.tv single. TV multi equals to find view by id TV multi selection. Set onclick listeners to both of the text views. Set onclick listener new view dot onclick listener. I have created a function for the dialogues. First one is single dialog and second one is multi dialog. So call it what this method does. First we have created an array list of 1 to 50 numbers, 0 to 50 numbers. Then we created an object of single selection dialog class. We need to pass two parameters to this. First one is the context, which I have given there, and second one is tag. If you are using the dialog for multiple purposes, this can help you in the future. Second thing we need to pass is the title, which will appear here on the toolbar. Second thing we need to pass the array list, which we are going to show in the dialog. So I have already created an array list. Third thing you need to pass is the color. So I have passed that color primary dark. You can also disable the search option via the given here false. I have given true, and then you can pass the hint for the search edit text. Then you need to pass is this text color. If you want to customize this, you can pass the text color for this. And last thing you need to pass is the listener. Listener will call when the user clicks on an option. The method call is on dialog item selected. If the dialog gets an error, it call on dialog error. Then last thing we need to do is to build this dot build. If you want to show the dialog here, you can call single selection dialog dot show method. Let's run the project and test. We got an error here. TV mail. Okay, our application has been installed on the device. If I click on the single selection, what we see is a dialog with our custom text, our custom hint and option. If I search for a number like 2, it shows all the numbers which have 2. If I enter a particular number, it will show that number. If I click on that, we get a value in this string s. On item selected, gets us give us three values. First one is the string which we have clicked. Second one is the position of the array list in which the item has been clicked, and last one is the tag which we have passed here. So set that value to this, or set tag as, and in error we get first string which is error and second one is tag. So we don't And in the multi dialog, what we get, first one is the string which is comma separated, comma space separated string, and second one is tag, and the last one is selected item list array list. All the item which user have selected will be provided here. So, and other functionality is the same like the single selection dialog. We can also set a default value here, dot set selected field. I will give it as a dot get text, well, dot get text dot to string. We can also pass here selected field. We need to pass a comma space separated value here. TV multi dot get text to string. We also show here multi selection dot set text. Yes. Let's test this. In the single selection, if I click on 5, what we are getting is 5. If I click on the multi selection, okay. I have not called the multi-selection function here. I called it run again. If I click on multi-selection, then I selected multiple options. What we're getting is the comma separated values. If I click on that, we have already setted this set selected field, so our default values are showing here. If I click on 5, 5 is added here. If I click on 6, 6 is added here. We are also getting a array list of string which have all the numbers like 0, 1, 2, 5, 6. So thank you for watching this video, guys.